not as an infant, but as a King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Jesus will return, and he's coming for those who have their lamps trimmed and burning, who are awake and ready. These are the words of Jesus. 1 Thessalonians 5, Paul focused on this a lot. He says, "No, brothers and sisters, about times and dates, we do not need to write to you, for you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. While people are saying peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly, as labor pains on a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, so that this day should surprise you like a thief. You are all children of the light and children of the day. We do not belong to the night or to the darkness. So then, let us not be like others who are asleep, but let us be awake and sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night. Those who get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober, putting on faith and love." We are called to be spiritually awake. And what does being spiritually awake look like? If we fall back to Proverbs chapter 10, verse 5, it says, "He who gathers crops in the summer is a prudent son, but he who sleeps during harvest is a disgraceful son." Bringing in the harvest, any farmer will tell you, requires getting up early and working while it is day. And now that they have tractors with lights, while it is night. But working while it's harvest time. Jesus spoke of harvest in terms of souls, didn't he? He said the harvest is plentiful. The laborers are few. The church is like a sleeping giant that snores during harvest time. An awake church, however, has a passion for sharing faith and leading people to Jesus. And I pray that this church will grow with people who are discovering Jesus for the first time and are coming to faith because you are leading them. What does a spiritually awake person look like? It's someone who has compassion and an interest in sharing Jesus with other people. Don't be caught sleeping. Ephesians 5, verse 14. What does a spiritually awake person look like? Listen to the words of this scripture. "Wake up, sleeper! Rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you." How do we wake up? How do we stay alert? It goes on in verse 15, Ron. "Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but wise, making the most of every opportunity because the days are evil. Do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Don't be drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit, speaking to one another in psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, making music from your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." And so spiritually awake people are careful how they live. They understand the will of God for their lives. They avoid drunkenness, but they get filled with the Spirit by praising and thanking and worshiping God whenever they have an opportunity. Spiritually awake. We need to guard our hearts from the evil one who wants to sneak into the garden of our inner lives, arrest us, and carry us away. You get the imagery of what the soldiers coming for Jesus? And Peter says, "I learned a lesson from a physical experience that I need and you need to be spiritually awake. Because Jesus is coming soon. We need to be awake during harvest time. And we need to live our lives wisely." I'm going to show you a video here. First of all, the next slide, Ron. "For you were once in darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light." This image is a piece of artwork done in response to General William Booth's vision, which propelled him to begin the Salvation Army. I won't get into the detail, but you can see that people are drowning. Those are people who don't know Christ. You'll see other people are on or alongside a big rock, the rock, Jesus Christ. Some of them are, very few of them are trying to reach out and help those who are drowning. Most of them are preoccupied with their own lives. Spiritually asleep. Do you get the imagery? Keith Green, one of the catalysts for modern contemporary Christian music, wrote a song called, it's a very biting song. It's called Asleep in the Light, and it chastises the church for being asleep in the light. As we listen to this song, you're going to see images from this scene here. I want you to listen to the words and ask what the Holy Spirit is saying to you this morning. Will you stand with me? Heavenly Father, your word tells us that you are the great shepherd. You expressed it through Jesus, the good shepherd. The shepherd carries a rod and a staff to lead, and a rod to correct. Sometimes we need to hear the truth in black and white, and we need to be woken up so that we turn our attention away from worthless things. We don't live in a world that's only populated by ourselves, but we think beyond us. And we have compassion for those who are like sheep without a shepherd. They're lost. Move in our hearts, God. Wake us and help us to be alert and on guard and to do your work to live our lives wisely. And if we can pray this prayer, I invite everyone to say, in Jesus' name.